Hi, welcome to the Linux channel. Viewers who have seen a few of my Linux kernel episodes and as well as especially my source code videos have asked me what is the IDE or the text editor which I am using, and I have replied them personally or via YouTube comments saying that I am using Bluefish IDE. And so I thought since I am getting these mails or queries once in a while, I thought let me take an interesting episode on Bluefish IDE, since not much people are aware of it, and I have quite seen in the open source world and as well as the commercial products where sometimes if they use something related like open source based IDE, they use Eclipse, and apart from that they use anyway the text based VA editor or gedit and tools like that. So what is the best thing I found in Bluefish is if you are into kernel space development, or if you are into web development, or if you are into user space C development and so on, you can use Bluefish IDE. It is basically a very lightweight text editor. At the same time, it will have some sort of all this format highlighting and stuff like that, like you find in any other IDE software. And apart from that, one of the great things about Bluefish is it is not required to create any kind of project file, whereas in case if you are using Eclipse or something, you need to create like a project file, and then each time you open the project, you need to open this project file, and it will load all your files and things like that. And sometimes you can anyway compile within the IDE as well. So such kind of features, I'm not sure is it even there existing in Bluefish IDE, but one of the great things is it is like any other text editor. At the same time, it has that versatility of using like an IDE, yes. So that's the best part of it, and which is why I chose to use Bluefish IDE ever since I have discovered it around some time ago. I'm not sure, I think around 5 or 6 years back. So I was quite fascinated because I'm looking around for a very simple to use IDE, especially for kernel space development and editing the kernel files. Because as many viewers know, I am not a person who writes any one or two files, kernel modules, whereas I need to even sometimes edit so many files inside the Linux kernel base. So in that case, I need to traverse to and fro. I need to suddenly jump into the header files, change the prototype of the APIs, and then jump back to the C files and change the source code of these API implementation and stuff like that. So I need an IDE which is very versatile. I can even edit the make files, and I can even write the change logs. I can even do update like any kind of bash scripts, installation scripts, because I don't use much the installation scripts within the make files as well. So instead I use a separate bash scripts, and these scripts I can trigger it via my PHP scripts as well. So it is a kind of complex soup. So I also sometimes update the SQL schema files, and I need to have an IDE which tackles all these things. And if it is GUI based programming, I use mainly PHP, and here and there few traces of JavaScripting, and apart from that plain HTML source as well. So it has to tackle all this, and this is an excellent IDE where I can highly recommend. And it is quite easy to install. It is with the apt-get, you can install just like that in Ubuntu. And earlier when yum is there in Fedora, you can use yum install, and you can use the the IDE is named Bluefish, and I think now you can use dnf command in Fedora. So in Ubuntu and Debian, you can choose to use apt-get and you can install Ubuntu. So what I can do is I can take you to my desktop, and unlike my previous episodes, I'm not going to discuss any specific source code traverser or something. I need to introduce a few features which I love about Bluefish IDE, and few things before even choosing to use, you need to change so that you can keep it customized. And you can use the most comfortable way. So that's the best way to put forward, because there are few things you need to change soon after you install the same. And I feel most of the programmers or developers may like also doing these changes. I'm not sure why the Bluefish team have done this defaults as well. So earlier when I initially started using it, it's quite little different way organized, whereas now it is a little different as well. So let's hop on to my desktop and let me show my Bluefish IDE. And I hope if you are working in kernel space, and if you are getting any kind of serious bugs, I highly recommend you can stop using your VI. And especially if you are like a beginner or some sort of intermediate level SS. So if you are very much advanced and you are into expert level and you are very comfortable with VI, then that's about it. But other than that, the text editors have the basic limitation of various things. So it's not a question of learning VI. I do know various commands and shortcuts in VI, but end of the day, we are all humans. We need an IDE or editor which is more human friendly. So that's why I can suggest Bluefish IDE. So kindly hop on to my desktop and let me show you its features. So guys, as you can see here, this is my Bluefish editor. So we can check the about box. As you can see here, it is version 227, and although the year looks like quite old and not updated, it is not much having any bugs so far for now. And I'm quite happy in terms of using the same, and quite just it crashes once in a while, like once in every 3 months or 6 months, so not too much worry about. But I highly recommend you to take any kind of backups in between while editing your source files. So as I said before, the best part of this IDE is it doesn't have any sort of project files to create, and you can just choose to use like this and assume this is your code where it starts. So this is the folder where in which your code starts. You can point it here, and in case you want to point it out of this scope, you can just use this and you can point it any location you want. So as an example, let us go to this folder. As you can see here, you can just do right click and you can do set as base dir, and this way you can set its base directory. And as you can see here, it is quite cool and it restricts the point of view, and this way you can focus on your code which you are supposed to edit. So what I can do is I can show a quick sample of a file, the way you can edit. And yeah, just before that, let me remind, this the tab you can see here will be positioned bottom most. And in case if you are installing the Bluefish for the first time, you need to choose to use this option so that it appears on the top. Otherwise it will appear like this, so which is not so comfortable, at least in the way I feel as so. You can just do this, and you can also change the fonts and other settings as such. Yeah, as you can see here, it again points on top. And there is another important setting you can do is the left side pane. You can adjust the view mode. There are various modes here. You can choose to use like flat, and it chooses a view like this, and you have to do somewhat like this, and it gives you a flat appearance. Something like this, which is not so quite comfortable, whereas you can choose to use the mode as tree. And this way you can see it is very easy to use, and it gives the easy way to parse your files across. So what I can do is I can open a test file, and we can see some of the features of Bluefish. As you can see here, it's a huge file, which is netcore dev.c in the Linux kernel source. And in this case, if you see, it is like almost thousands of lines, and it is extremely easy to parse across these lines, and you can edit the same. And it doesn't have any sort of features where you create a project and then hop with respect to each of these symbol names and stuff like that. But it's a very good text editor with the same features like any other IDE, like you can use this highlighting of your code and color themes and stuff like that. You can choose to use somewhat like this, and you can expand and minimize any sort of use as per your choice, as you can see here. And it is also customizable, and in case you want all this comments to be in some other color, you can choose to use, you can change its background and settings like that in fonts and color options as well. So it's a cool editor, as you can see here, and it is extremely lightweight and extremely fast, and this is the reason I love about it. And it is not based on any Java based IDE or something, so it is extremely lightweight, extremely fast in that context. And other than that, in case if you are a web developer, you may like this HTML bar, and it has this snippets menu and stuff like that. So once you initially install this IDE, you will get all these features, whereas I never use even for any GUI development, so I never enable the same. So as a sample, I can even open any HTML or PHP files. And just in case you are a web developer, as you can see here, it is very versatile. Let me open a PHP file. As you can see here, it has also all sorts of code highlighting which you can use, as you can see here. And any HTML files, it is going to highlight like this, and this way you won't get any bugs. So it is going to highlight the starting tags and ending tags like this. So this is the reason I love this interface. It automatically identifies the files, and it does everything as any other basic IDE. And you can disable this, and you can disable this snippets menu, and this way it will look very minimal, but at the same time it has almost all the features. And other than that, you can also check the options like upload, where you can install any of your HTML files within your local server, and then you can do any sorts of tests. Suppose this is my entire HTML base which I need to install it in Verilog, HTML I can choose to use, and I can choose to use like upload, and it will install over here. So this way it is quite easy. Once you update your code, you can just install it, and immediately you can test it in a browser as well. So apart from that, the installation goes somewhat like this. You can check sudo dpkg -- list grep as you can see, this is the application name. So you can choose to use a sudo apt-get install bluefish. Since it is already been installed, it is saying this message. So in case if you have Fedora, you can use DNF or yum based on the versions you choose. And it is quite easy to install and easy to use. And once it has been installed, you can create a shortcut like this, just the way I have done. It will appear over here, and you can drag it and create a shortcut over here. So once you close and once you open, it will stay in this position, and you can reopen the file. And you can also, the other cool feature is you can see all the recently opened the files, and you can say, for example, you open 3-4 files and you are done with editing each of these files, and you can directly go here and say save all, and it will save all the files in one shot. You can also close all the files in one shot, just the way I have shown to you. So this is why I love the Bluefish editor, and this is the reason I'm using it from past many years. And you can also use to edit simple plain text files just like this. And in case there are any scripts, say there is a bash script, as you can see here, even it is going to highlight any of these scripts. And apart from that, you have any SQL schema file, it is also going to highlight this SQL schema file. So it is almost a complete circle of features, whatever you can dream about. And you have any make files, it is also going to highlight the make file options. And so that's why I love the Bluefish editor. So let me see. Yeah. Yeah, as you can see here, assume you are doing something editing in kconfig, it is quite easy to edit, as well as this kernel make files and just about anything. So this is the reason I use Bluefish editor. So that's all guys for this episode. I hope you liked watching this video. Please give a thumbs up if you like this video, and please do subscribe to this channel. And in case if you have any queries or any video suggestions, please post it across in YouTube comments. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.